Hey, church family, I'm so glad that you joined us today for this week's devotional. And if you're watching from home, then I would encourage you to go ahead and pause this video, gather up your family, and spend the next 10 minutes with me as we study God's Word together. And then after this video is over, I would challenge you to have your family still together and have a small group time where you're going to go over some small group questions. These questions are designed to help you go deeper into the lesson, the devotional, and also kind of to see the application of the lesson in your own life. There's just going to be three questions, and you'll see them posted with this video, so they're not going to take long, but I certainly believe that it would be worth your time. All right, well, we are in week two of our current teaching series that I'm calling Satan's Favorite Arrows, and as I mentioned last week, I'm calling this series that because the Bible tells us, and 1 Peter 5:8, that our adversary, that being Satan, is prowling around like a roaring lion looking for anyone he can devour. So, like a hunter hunts his prey and oftentimes shoots an arrow at it, the Bible tells us that Satan is essentially doing the same thing to us. He is hunting us and wants nothing more than to see us fall away from our faith in God. And oftentimes, he attempts to do that in the most stealthiest of ways, as we will see today. So, would you pray with me as we open up God's Word, as we look at this devotional for this week? Father, I thank you so much for just this chance that we can set aside in our day, God, to be under your feet, as we'll see here in a moment, to study your Word. And so, Father, I pray that those watching right now, whether they're at home, whether they're listening in a car, God, I pray that it would bless them. I pray that it would encourage them. And ultimately, Father, I pray that it would draw them closer to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, never before in our history have we been so busy and so distracted with many different things. For example, just the other day I was driving in town and I had stopped at a red light. And as I looked to my right, I saw this woman. She was sitting there at the red light. She was putting on mascara. She was talking on the phone. She was eating breakfast all at the same time. We are very busy people. In fact, if I were to guess, many of you who are listening or watching right now, you're probably doing something else, or at least you're thinking of all the other things that you have to accomplish today. But for all of our busyness, are we seeing progress? For all the good things we're seeking to do and attempt to serve the Lord, are we still making a point to personally spend time with Him? That's today's talk, because I believe busyness is an arrow that Satan shoots at many of us today. So if you have your Bible, I hope you do. I want to go ahead and invite you to get that out, maybe pull it up on your phone if that's easier, and go ahead and turn with me to Luke chapter 10. We'll be in Luke chapter 10 today, because within this chapter is probably the best example that I can think of busyness in the entire Bible. It's the story of Mary and Martha, and it begins in verse 38 by saying this. It says, "While they were traveling, Jesus entered a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. She had a sister named Mary, who also sat at the Lord's feet and was listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by her many tasks, and she came up and asked, 'Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to serve alone? So tell her to give me a hand.' The Lord answered her, 'Martha, Martha, you are worried and upset about many things, but one thing is necessary. Mary has made the right choice, and it will not be taken away from her.'" I would imagine for many of you listening today, this is probably a very familiar passage that you've heard preached on several different times. But for those of you who maybe aren't as familiar with this story, let me just kind of help you paint the picture and see what's going on here. Mary and Martha were sisters, and they were good friends with Jesus too. So it shouldn't be a surprise that when Jesus entered their village, he came to stay at their house. Now, it doesn't say this anywhere in Scripture, but if I were to guess that when they heard that Jesus, the Messiah, the Son of God, was coming to visit them, there was probably some type of mad dash to get everything cleaned and get everything done and make their house look perfect before he arrived. I know that's certainly the case when I have company coming over. When we know that someone's going to come over to our house, we're frantically trying to clean everywhere. We're trying to put the dirty socks underneath the couch and sweep the dust underneath the bed. So I can only imagine how frantically they must have been trying to get everything cleaned and put up before he knocked on their door. But when he finally did, I want you to notice the different responses that Mary and Martha had. Mary immediately stopped what she was doing. The text tells us that she sat at Jesus' feet and listened to what he said. For obvious reasons, Jesus was the guest of honor, and Mary made sure to give her his full attention as he began to speak to them. Martha, however, had a completely different response. Her and Mary must not have gotten everything done, so instead of sitting at Jesus' feet, the text tells us that Martha was distracted by her many tasks. And this must have frustrated Martha because she complains to Jesus that Mary's not helping her with anything anymore, and she wants Jesus to actually tell Mary to get up and help her finish the tasks that are at hand. But notice Jesus' response. It's found in verses 41 through 42. Let's read those again. The Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and upset about many things, but one thing is necessary." How like that part where it says one thing? One thing is necessary. Mary has made the right choice, and it will not be taken away from her. Martha was doing a good thing. She had a good heart. She wanted to serve Jesus, but unlike Mary, she had not done the one thing that was needed. And that one thing was to sit at the feet of Jesus. Because sitting at the feet of Jesus implies readiness to accept and obey what Jesus teaches. It implies submitting yourself to him, putting your faith in him. It implies discipleship and having a love and adoration for him. You see, Mary understood this. She knew that even though that there were still tasks that might need it to be done, her greatest and most important task in this moment was to sit at the feet of Jesus and spend time with him. Martha, however, missed this opportunity. Even though she was doing good things in an attempt to serve Jesus, she ended up getting frustrated because she didn't focus on the one thing that mattered the most, which is always, always to sit at the feet of Jesus. Here's my point as it relates to our devotional and our scripture today. Satan can sometimes use good things as a weapon against us. Let me say that again because that's basically my devotional in one sentence. Satan can sometimes use good things as weapons against us. He can form them into arrows of busyness and shoot them at us. Because while we're seeking to serve Jesus at church and at home and at our workplace, and that's a good thing, if we get so busy and so caught up in them, so consumed in them, then we'll miss the one thing that Jesus wants us to do the most. And that one thing is to sit at his feet, to personally spend time with him. Because no matter how well we might be serving Jesus, if we aren't personally spending any time with Jesus, then we are neglecting our relationship with him, even if our day is focused on serving him. And let me tell you, as a pastor, I'll just be honest right here, I'm constantly fighting this battle myself. Because even though I may spend most of my day reading and studying the scriptures and seeking to minister to others, if I'm not taking the time to personally have a quiet time with Jesus and spend time sitting under his feet, then my relationship with him will suffer. Because even though I may be pouring myself out to others, if I'm not sitting under his feet and being filled up with his spirit, then I will be left feeling tired, feeling worn, and not having a close personal relationship with him. So the first thing that I try to do each and every day in the stillness and quietness of the morning before my day gets hectic, before my day gets busy, is I try to have a quiet time with Jesus. And I don't use it to study for upcoming sermons. I use that time to sit under his feet, to personally be filled up by him, because that's the one thing that matters the most. When I fill myself up with him, then I can pour myself out to others and serve him, never feeling tired, never feeling worn or weary, because I am being constantly filled up with him by sitting under his feet. That's the one thing that Jesus desires most from each and every one of us. Church family, I know that you may not be a pastor like me, but I also know this. I also know that you're busy like me. And while you might have a good heart, and while you may want to serve Jesus at church and at home and in the workplace, if you're not sitting under His feet and you're not spending personal time with Him in a daily devotional, then you will end up feeling frustrated and feeling defeated, just as Martha did in the text as we read a few moments ago. Make time to sit at Jesus' feet. Have a quiet time with Him. Use it to be filled up with His Spirit. Because when you do, you'll be able to fend off the arrow of busyness that Satan seeks to use against us. Let's pray. Father, I thank You so much for Your Word, for the reminders that are found in it. And God, as we think about the arrows that Satan sometimes shoots at us, Father, sometimes they're arrows that seem to really be good things. And Father, seeking to serve You at church, seeking to serve You as we minister to our families and seek to be good husbands and wives and fathers and mothers and students, Father, even in those good things, if we're not careful, God, Satan can use those against us. He can use those things to help us to be so consumed where we're neglecting to spending time with Jesus. And Father, that's the most important thing. The most important thing is not seeking to serve You here and there, because if that's all we're focused on, then we're not spending a personal time with You. We're not having a personal relationship with You. And so, Father, I pray that we would sit under Your feet. That's the one thing that You want from us the most. And God, help us to be filled up with Your Spirit and Your Spirit alone. And God, help us to fight off the arrow of busyness that Satan sometimes throws at us so that we can focus ourselves on You and live for You and serve You when we do those things. In Jesus' name, amen.